When I came out as transgender in the world of professional football, I was terrified that I would never work in the game again. I had friends who were so scared of the response I would get from fans that they just didn't want me to go back. And yet the love and support that I received from fans and players just filled my heart with joy. Now, campaign group Kick It Out is trying their best to break down not only racism but also homophobia within the game.
Well, we're very conscious of the fact that racism is just not a one-way street. And we recognise that when we started to fight and challenge racism in football, what we saw was total opposition to black players playing the game, and all the abuse was going in one direction. But prejudice affects us all. And so it's more than a one-way street. And we recognise that in trying to tackle racism, we also have to tackle sexism, because there are black men who are biased against women. And then there are all the other discriminations that figure as part of our prejudice. Homophobia, anti-Islamic Islamophobia. All these things form part of our society, which we have to encourage people to tackle, but also to help to educate the next generation to understand how discrimination occurs as a result of not understanding our prejudices and managing those prejudices. So as Kick It Out, we seek to help anyone that is confronting discrimination and to help them to be able to be equipped to tackle their own prejudices and fight discrimination.
Do you feel that the threat of abuse from fans and teammates is a big barrier to a player coming out as gay?
I think inevitably, unless you've got the right conditions and the right environment, that someone knows they're going to be supportive, both in terms of where they play, but in the wider environment in which they have to exist, then they're going to be reluctant. And we know that is the reason why any gay footballers haven't come out as yet. We've seen women playing the game quite open about their sexuality, and that's great, and you could see people accept it, they embrace it. It's got to be that way. We've got to be positive of people and who they are and what they bring to our society, and I think we now have got to try and make sure that we get men to feel more confident. I think football has moved quite a long way in terms of the playing environment that is ready to help to encourage, but it's still hard for an individual knowing the macho-ness that exists in football, and also the prejudice that are still in people's minds, who will say things in private because they think it's okay. But that prejudice, I think, feeds into the psyche of the individual who may want to come out but feel they're not ready for this.
When I came out with AFC Bournemouth, I was scared because there was no history of a trans person working within football, but I was met with amazing support from the players. How much do you think that a player coming out as gay would feel the same support from their teammates?
I firmly believe we're in a better place than we've ever been. And I hope that that would be the condition. You just don't know. You only need one or two people to be really silly and for us to not take things further back. I think we're probably very close, but we've got to keep working to create that understanding that people are sufficiently sensitive that even if they dislike someone because of their sexuality, they're not going to allow that to get in the way of enabling that person to thrive and to exist as an equal within our society. And that's really what we're trying to do as part of our work, is getting people to say, look, we know you're not going to like everyone, and this is not about, we can't like everyone, but you have got to treat everyone with respect, and you've got to understand, and we've got to help. Our job is to help people to come to terms with that, to understand, I don't need you to like me, I'd like you to treat me with dignity and respect, and because I want to treat you that way, whatever your background, whatever your sexuality, whatever your appearance, whatever your circumstances. And that's as much as we can do, and we're trying hard with that.
This is Sophie Cook for latest TV news.